Hey guys, this is the Cerberus Ultimate Damage by Xeon X90. Look at this thing, it's huge. Alright, let's see here. I'm gonna give you guys a quick wall crown first, I guess. Oh, pretty. Rear lights on the thing. Ooh. Now that's how you make a tank on space engineers. So, the Cerberus costs 12,967 PC with 1,761 blocks. Alright. Some spotlights for the actual lights to the front. And, you know, some neon lights for the decorative lights thingy. Well, they actually function as some kind of an indicator light, you know. A gyroscope to the front. Well, that does protect the, you know, the thing behind the gyroscope, but well, that does make the gyroscope kind of a little bit exposed, and especially since this, you know, this tank is supposed to shoot forward. Well, not really, but you know, if the tank is shot from the front, then the gyroscope can be easily damaged. To the right side of the tank, more light and some decorative element. An autocannon turret. So this is a large grid vehicle with a small grid turret thingy. Now that's only partially small grid because these things are large grid stuff. Yeah, that's a pretty complex turret configuration. We got an air fan, but this is only for decoration because it's not really connected to anything. Under the tank we got some batteries and, you know, some AI block as well. A space ball. That's the reactor. More gyroscope of the tank. H2 generator. Small hydrogen tank. Is that some kind of an entrance? No, that's a cryo chamber. Interesting placement, but well, it is nice to have a cryo chamber or a bed on a vehicle so that, you know, you can just lock off in the vehicle or whatever. To the back of the tank, we got some thrusters. I'm guessing to help this tank accelerate. Those are the rear lights that we saw earlier. A remote control block and a camera. Decorative element using the lockers. Shelf. There's a survival kit on this tank, which is a good thing because, well, that means people can respawn on the tank. And the turret of the tank is rather, I mean, that's kind of looks exposed, but well, it's actually kind of rather protected, I guess. But look at the main weapon though. That's a lot of assault cannons. Now this is firepower. To the sides of the thing. I thought these were rocket launchers before, but these are actually firework launchers. Probably for countermeasures like flares and chaff to the top of the turret. An oxygen farm. So if this tank can be used on, you know, places without oxygen, then is this even connected to anything? Never mind. This is probably just for decoration. Another remote control block here. So I'm guessing a lot of these things are just decoration. But you know, some of them can actually be used because, well, you can always use the remote control even though it's, you know, kind of the wrong way around. And you can definitely use the ore detector as well. But you know, some of them, like the oxygen farm, is not functional at all. A small warfare reactor and a spotlight. Alright, I guess that's pretty much the whole exterior. I see the entrance. Alright, let's see here. Interesting interior view. Those are the controls. Camera view. Fancy. Is this the flare button? I was expecting something more dramatic, but you know, this is the custom turret controller. Let me try shooting. That's beautiful. Remote controls. And you know, some of the other controls as well. Yeah, this is a pretty heavy tank. Even with the thrusters turned on, it's kind of slow, but this is actually like, yeah, this is actually feel properly, you know, heavy. Like it feels heavy, but it doesn't feel sluggish. Yeah, I actually really like the handling on this vehicle. And well, since we have a very large, you know, a very large gun, I'm pretty sure this can actually do substantial damage to actual warships. Alright, I got my warship. Here goes. And that's why he won a lot of firepower. This is one of those tanks that can actually do a considerable damage on space engineers. Warning, no atmosphere beyond this point. I was shooting at a ground vehicle earlier, but my recording messed up. Alright, watch this. This is what's gonna happen if you shoot at another ground vehicle. That's actually more dramatic than what happened before. Oh, that's crazy. It pulled the whole vehicle upward and, you know, bits of the vehicle got stuck down there. Very nice. Against most ground vehicles out there, this vehicle can, well, it can probably destroy most of them in one shot. I guess if you want to have a crew on this vehicle, then the only other place for them to sit down is in the cryo chamber. Well, I mean, I guess they can always just, you know, stand here or whatever. But you know, the only way for them to sit down is using the cryo chamber. Alright, let's see how well this tank can go downhill. I'm gonna go slowly so we actually roll down the hill. Alright. We do have quite a large... come on. We have a high ground clearance. Come on. No. And we have, like, you know, gyroscopes control as well. Wait a second. I went all the way downhill without taking any damage. All those years of practice going downhill paid off. But yeah, as you guys can see there, because you know the tank has like a large wheel, I mean has large wheels and a very high ground clearance as well, and you know, good gyroscope control, this is actually really doable in going downhill without taking any damage. That's actually pretty impressive. But alright, what the hell? I copy-pasted the vehicle a little bit too low to the ground and I'm guessing the subgrid just clang or something. Alright, here goes. I'm gonna crash the vehicle this time, turning off the power. Are we gonna roll? Come on, start rolling. What the hell? There we go. So when the vehicle does crash, because you know the vehicle is a large grid vehicle and it has like hydrogen tanks and stuff in the vehicle, it's actually not that survivable if you do crash the vehicle. But you know, as long as you stay in control of the vehicle, it should be fine. Look at the things that are left from the crash. Oh, the gun survived though. Just be careful when driving the vehicle. Oh, the tank actually has like an auto aim thingy. Alright, I gotta disable shooting for a bit so the tank doesn't just shoot at the enemy base right after I spawn the tank. This is not gonna be a fair fight at all. I guess I can start closer to the enemy base so they have you know, an actual chance to actually shoot at us. Alright, let's see how well this tank can deal with an enemy base. I'm gonna allow shooting. Did we just win the battle? Well, There's actually a ladder here, so I guess someone can, you know, just sit in there or hold onto the ladder or, you know, just get in the cage if they want to stay in the tank without getting thrown out. Alright, I guess this would be a more fair fight then. I mean, you know, the ship won't be controlled by anyone, but the ship does have a lot more guns. So, you know. Alright, let's see how well this tank can deal with an enemy ship. Ooh, come on, start moving. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Whoa, fire. Oh, we lost the turret. Oh, wait a second. Alright, let's see how close we can get to the bottom of the enemy ship before we get completely destroyed. Come on, keep moving. The frame of the tank is actually rather sturdy. Keep moving. What the hell? We're actually tanking artillery fire. There we go. Alright, hold on. Let's see how much damage we did to the enemy ship. Yeah, we got like a single shot or two shots maybe. That's quite a lot of damage, especially coming from a ground vehicle. I've never seen a ground vehicle do that much damage to actual warships before. That's actually kind of crazy. If it's like a smaller ship or smaller warship, you will actually have a good chance of winning as long as you get the first shot at the ship. The durability or endurance of the tank is also quite, you know, quite good actually. You saw how the tank took like a lot of artillery and getting fire shot before finally being disabled. But yeah, well, I'm actually kind of surprised. I was thinking or expecting that this is gonna be, you know, some kind of a meme vehicle. But this is actually a pretty capable ground combat vehicle. I mean, you know, there are some downsides like the design of the things, like, you know, the exposed stuff down here and some of the decorations that don't really do anything, as well as maybe the exposed turret down here. But, you know, in terms of survival, you can actually do quite a bit with this vehicle because it does have the or detector and the H2 generator and the survival kit as well, so you can do a basic level of production as well on this vehicle. Does this thing have actual refineries though? No refinery, no assembler. I guess you can actually modify the vehicle to have, like, you know, refineries or assemblers, so, you know, not the most efficient or practical survival vehicle ever, but well, it is rather usable in survival. And it's actually a really good ground combat vehicle. Say, that's the Cerberus by Xeon X90. You guys can find the link in the description below. That's actually a really nice vehicle. I like it. I wish the air vents are actually functional though. You can probably carry a lot of stuff on this thing as well. I'm pretty sure you can actually, hold on, carry this warship with that many wheels. Dampeners off. I was actually expecting the ship to just fall off and explode, but what the hell? How is it stable? That's actually pretty impressive.